Here we have a first order reaction, and we're given the rate constant at 470 degrees C, and we're given the activation energy for the reaction. And we want to know, at what temperature does the rate constant equal 4.36 times 10 to the minus 3 seconds to minus 1? Let's list our information. Let's call this temperature 1, 470 degrees C. The rate constant at this temperature is given. And then a temperature that we don't know, call this temperature 2. And we're given the rate constant at this temperature. It's larger, as we expect, because of the activation energy. And so what we know is that rate constant equals some pre-exponential factor, an activation energy over the gas constant, and the absolute temperature. And since we have the rate constants, we need the temperature. Easiest to work with this if we take the log. So the log of the rate constant, the natural log of K0 minus activation energy over RT. Essentially, what I'm going to do is saying at temperature 1, we have rate constant 1, and I'm going to write the equation again for temperature 2. So same equation, but just for the other temperature. And now I'm going to subtract these two equations so that I have the log K1 minus the log of K2. These terms will cancel when you subtract. And then on the right side, minus E over R times 1 over T1 minus 1 over T2, keeping the minus sign in front. Then I can write this as the log of K1 over the log of K2, and the right side is the same. And now I can substitute in values. And notice, of course, the units for K cancel, and that's important because we're taking log of a dimensionless number. And now we'll substitute in for the activation energy and the gas constant. So the gas constant I use, notice that my units have to be consistent. So 10 to the third joules is a kilojoule. And now the units are consistent. And then temperature has to be absolute temperature. Temperature 1. So 470 degrees C. I'm going to add 273.2. This is going to give me the temperature in Kelvin, and I'm going to solve for the new temperature also will be in Kelvin. So now I've done some of the multiplication. I take this log, it's a negative number, minus 3.679. I can now solve for T2. And I would solve by first doing this division, and then I could bring this to the other side, 1.345 times 10 to the minus 3. And that equals minus 1 over T2. So I can now solve for T2, which is going to be in Kelvin. And now I can convert this back to centigrade by subtracting. And my temperature to have this rate constant would be 540 Kelvin.